Renewables have become crazy cheap, but that's not enough to fix climate change. You see, we've got a fossil fuel habit that we need to kick. Actually, that reminds me of something that happened to me at the doctor's a few years back. Hi, doctor.
Great to see you again.
You really are too sweet.
Oh, thank you.
No, I've analysed your blood and it really is too sweet. It's like it's made up of soda.
That might be because I spend most of my time drinking fizzy drinks.
Most of your? Well, maybe not most, perhaps just like 11 hours a day.
Well, look, you get that drinking all that soda is bad. So you seriously need to start drinking diet soda. Your life depends on it.
Now, you might just think that I did what the doctor advised, and you'd be wrong. You see, this was a long time ago when...
Diet soda is just too expensive. There's no way I can buy all that.
But surely you can't put a price on your own life.
I wouldn't have thought so either, but here we are.
Luckily, as time ticked on, the situation changed.
Time has ticked on and the situation has changed. Diet soda is now seriously cheap. Sometimes even cheaper than regular soda.
Oh, that's great news. I guess it's finally time for me to start taking this health emergency seriously.
Which reminds me of how we've treated renewables. For years, we've just complained that they're too expensive. And even years ago, this barely made any sense since it doesn't take account of all the subsidies we have on fossil fuels.
And it doesn't begin to take account of the very real human and economic cost that fossil fuels are causing today and will continue causing in the future. I mean, how do you begin to assess the cost of lives lost to air pollution or uprooted by extreme weather? Okay, but this was the narrative, and even today I still get these kinds of comments. Saying,
yeah, it would be great to move on from fossil fuels, but everyone knows that renewables are just too expensive.
Except that's just not true anymore. In recent years, the price of wind and solar have plummeted, so much so that the International Energy Agency last year announced that solar is the cheapest source of electricity in history. And to any engineering skeptics out there, yes, that does take account of intermittency. And all of this is great, right? Well, that's what you would have thought, and it's what I had thought about my newfound love of diet soda.
So, Doc, I've been following your advice and have been drinking loads of diet soda.
That is ill.
Kind of a dated expression there, but thanks.
No, I mean, you're still seriously ill. Your blood is full of sugar.
But that doesn't make any sense. I've been drinking loads of diet soda.
And that must have substantially reduced your regular soda intake.
No way. I'm still drinking loads of soda. More now, if anything. I'm just drinking that tasty diet soda to counteract it.
But surely you get that that's ridiculous. The whole point was for you to reduce the amounts of regular soda that you're drinking.
Now look, Doc, I think you're being a bit harsh. Surely we should be celebrating this big win for my body.
It isn't a big win for your body though. You're still doing just as much damage as you were when you first had this conversation. I mean, what do you have to say for yourself?
Okay, honestly, the thing is that none of this ever actually happened. At least none of this stuff about the soda. It happens every single day when we're talking about renewables.
You see, we focus on the huge amounts of solar and wind being built around the world. And for good reason, this is a huge change from just a few years ago. In fact, solar and wind together are projected to overtake coal and gas individually in just the next few years. But unfortunately, the atmosphere doesn't care about any of that. Why? Because the amount the world warms depends only on the amount that we emit. That means it doesn't matter if we build 5 wind turbines or 5 million wind turbines, because if we're still burning the same amount of fossil fuels in those two scenarios, the world is still warming by the same amount. In other words,
you can't just add the good thing to the bad thing. You actually have to replace the bad thing with the good thing.
Remember how I said that renewables were going to overtake coal and gas? Well, when you actually look at that projection, it's all down to the rise of renewables, not any real decrease in coal or gas. The soaring success of solar and wind is something to celebrate. Their cheap cost is stopping us from building more fossil fuel infrastructure than we otherwise would have.
But we already have so much fossil fuel infrastructure that it risks blowing us past the climate limits we've agreed as safe. So ultimately, we need to stop focusing on how much renewable energy we're building. And instead, we need to ask, how much coal, oil, and gas are we getting rid of? I just wanted to say hello to everyone who is new to this channel. It is amazing to see this community growing every single day now. If you'd like to help that growth, then why not share this video with friends, with family who you think might enjoy it? Okay, until next time, bye.